Okay, let's go over this one last time. My name is Becky Morrison. I was bitten by a radioactive spider. Okay, that was a lie. I was bitten by a spider. It just wasn't radioactive. And it wasn't even on my hat either. It was more around my wrist around there. So, yeah. And for 3 years, I have been cosplaying the one and only Spider-Man. I'm pretty sure you know the rest. I've attended so many comic book conventions, have helped out with some charity work, and helped host some birthday parties again and again and again. And I did this. Yeah, we don't really talk about that. I have bought tons of Spider-Man costumes, as well as make my own. I've reenacted my favorite Spider-Man moments from any films he's been in, bringing internet Spider-Man memes to life, even the obvious one, some embarrassing dance moves, attempted to lift Thor's hammer and fail twice, read Spidey comics, taken some real snazzy photos, more embarrassing dance moves, have entered as many cosplay competitions as I could, at least before I busted my leg that one time in front of an entire audience that I still feel humiliated by to this day. Helped my local cinema promote the new Marvel films coming out, and most of all, made new friends in the cosplay community. Especially the other Spider-Man cosplayers I've met along the way, sharing the love and passion for a character we all look up to. Always reminding me of why I love being Spider-Man. So no matter what hate or challenges I get thrown my way, I will keep doing what I love. Anyone can be Spider-Man, but there's only one Hex and Vex. And you're looking at her.
So yeah, you can obviously tell that I really enjoyed Into the Spider-Verse.
Greetings, my fellow people. I am Hex and Bex, and...
Are you in the know?
Well, now you're about to know. About to know how to make the Scarlet Spider suit. But Becky, there's more than one Scarlet Spider. Which one do you mean? Why, I'm talking about good old Ben Reilly, you silly dingus.
Wow, that wasn't very Scottish of you to say, Becky.
Who cares?
At least my dialect isn't completely confusing, unlike the Clone Saga. But many of us can agree that one of the few good things that came out of that comic was a kick-ass costume. It's a pretty easy build, and it makes sense that there's not that many cosplay tutorials about it. But hell, I'm gonna do it anyway. I mean, hey, it'll be fun, right?
So what you'll need is a red morph suit,
a blue hoodie, black straps, along with a buckle, pouches that you can easily get from a Deadpool belt, a clip-on belt, perforated vinyl,
plastic which you can get from a bottle or a fishbowl, hot glue, black puff paint, then finally,
Nerf darts, or 12-gram CO2 cartridges. So why am I mentioning two options to make the web shooters? I made a mistake.
What?
I did first was buy a Nerf wristband, which is perfect for the Scarlet Spider's web shooters. I would just need to coat it in black paint. No biggie.
But for some reason, I bought blue darts. Not gray, blue. So at the time I thought, hey, why don't I just spray paint the foam darts silver? That'll work out well.
And so I did. And then what happened? It got all over my freaking costume.
God damn it, I had a whole montage set up. Even a Spider-Man Unlimited joke. What a waste!
But then I took this chance to see if I can make something closer to the PS4 web shooters. So get your black straps, Velcro, glue, and canisters ready and get crafting. First, you take the black strap and measure it around your wrist.
Not precise measurements, but I'm more freehanding it and going by rough estimates. Then you're gonna grab your Velcro strap and measure it up with the normal strap. Yeah, it's very easy to do. You just need to cut it off where it meets. It's simple. Then glue all of those Velcro pieces down. Make sure the rough side of the Velcro and the soft side of the Velcro are on opposite sides so then that way it can attach. So be certain to double check before you glue it all down.
Otherwise, congratulations! You've made a wristband. Give it a few test wears so you know you've done it right. Okay, let's go ahead and add these canisters in, shall we? Wrap a piece of strap around the canister so that you measure how much you need. Then apply hot glue onto the canister and stick a piece of strap onto it. Make sure it doesn't go falling off now, okay? Apply more glue to the black strap and wrap it around the canister. Hold it down for a bit and you're ready to put it onto your wristband. Add more glue again, hold it down, and repeat 7 to 10 times because you never know how many web cartridges you need for your web shooter. Flip it good! Lay your wristband on a flat surface, add on the rest of the cartridges, and there you have it, a pair of web shooters. And you can do the same thing for the belt, and even the ankle pouches. Boy, used buckles instead.
So now that part is over, let's focus on the suit itself.
The red suit came in just how I liked it. You don't really need to add anything to it. It's fine with how it is. Pretty much the same deal with the hoodie as well.
Though I did decide to rip out the front pocket as I don't think it's really needed for this costume. I misplaced my stitch ripper, but luckily I had a little friend to help me out. You're always there when I need you, blood and mud covered duck pin.
I'm gonna crack your head open.
Now, I know what many of you are going to be saying. But Becky, those are not the right colors! The red and the blue should be a brighter shade! That is not comic accurate!
Well, first off, Ben is from the 90s. That way he should look a little bit more, you know, grungy. And what screams 90s grunge more than denim blue or flannel red?
Second, there's been many comic panels showcasing Ben's costume in a darker shade.
It's called the Scarlet Spider, not the Maroon Spider.
Oh, Maroon is just a dark scarlet then, for God's sake. Your complaints would make sense if I did it a completely different color, like the indigo insect, the amber arachnid. Hell, if it makes you feel better, you can call me the Crimson Crab. Though I don't think you should do that either, because of, dealing with, Third, it's my personal preference. I just like the color scheme a little better. I mean, hey, it's my costume. If I want to make it a darker shade, then I'll do it.
Right, let's start on the hoodie now. Draw whatever spider emblem you want on your hoodie onto an A2 sheet of paper. Cut it out and pin your template onto the pillow and cardboard placed underneath the hoodie.
Then grab your puff paint and brushes and apply it all over the template. Be precise and be patient. Take as much time as you need, and be sure to apply not too much, but not too less either. And then BOOM! You got a fine ass looking logo on your hoodie! I mean, damn, that looks good! Like, WOO!
And now the final part. Working on the mask and working on applying the shoes to the suit. Make sure to have a full station ready. There's gonna be a lot of glue and a lot of pen marking here. It might get messy if you ain't careful. Right, first thing you do is stick the perforated vinyl onto your plastic. It's like applying a giant sticker, so make sure it's neat. Then get the eye template that you've drawn and cut out for yourself and mark it onto the plastic. Then cut it following the marks you've made, while again, being precise and patient. And then there you go, a nice clean set of lenses for your mask. Then rinse and repeat a second time. Now in order to attach the lenses correctly onto my mask, I have to make sure that I wear the face shell underneath so that I don't burn my face when applying glue onto it. That would be disastrous. Then give it a test to see if it fits on your head well. And there we go, a great success to making the Scarlet Spider mask. Hell to the freaking yeah.
All that is left is applying the shoes into your suit. Get a pair of slip-on sports shoes, put on the suit while wearing them, then mark and cut open a slit underneath the shoe sole, then apply hot glue and stick the fabric onto it.
Be very careful.
But since I don't have any rubber bands to press the fabric into the shoe sole, I've gotta stand around and watch Impractical Jokers for about 30 minutes or 40. I did not think this through, did I? At least Poppy will keep me company in the meantime. God, I love her.
And alas, it is finished. Making this costume was super fun, and it's probably one of my most favorite cosplays so far. And that says a lot compared to what I've worked on before.
And thank you guys so much for watching this tutorial. I hope it's really helpful. So, were you in the know? Well, now you do know. Funny! What I like to know is who you are and what you're doing in my house! Ah, goat's cheese. Well... You see, roll it!
Okay, let's go over this one last time. My name is Wendy Fryer. I remember getting bitten by a radioactive-
No! We've already done this thing! Stop it! Alright, I'll ask you one last time. Who are you and what are you doing in my house? Isn't it obvious, Becky? I'm your clone.
Or maybe you're my clone. Or maybe I am the clone, but I'm not the first clone, as I'm a clone brought to life by having our DNA injected into a random corpse, and not the previous clone who was grown in a lab. Wow, that sounds annoying and needlessly complicated. Ah, but being complicated means it makes you think, therefore it's clever. No, does it make you clever? It overrides your brain with stupidity and makes you want to punch someone! Speaking of which... Oh, okay, look! Look! The reason I'm here is because of what you said on Instagram. What did I say on Instagram? That you're quitting cosplay and getting fed up with it? I never said that! I'm not quitting, and I'm sure as hell not getting fed up with it. All I said is I was taking a break. That's all. Even what you said about getting away from Spider-Man stuff? Well, yeah. Not completely. Look, Spider-Man is something I associate with, but it's not the only thing I want to associate with. I want to do other things. I want to have more variation in my content. I want to be known for something just outside of all that. It's just... just been all about Spider-Man, hiding behind a mask for everyone, and forgotten to tend to the person underneath. Yeah, exactly. I just can't let this one thing consume my life. Otherwise, it's all I have. I know that feeling. A little too well. Yeah. Then don't let it. Huh? Well, if you don't want that to happen, then do something about it. Something different. Like what? Perhaps start talking about films that you've seen, but other people haven't seen, or even heard of? Underappreciated TV shows? A certain video game that you're fond of? Hell, why don't you make cosplay videos on other characters you enjoy? Expand your ideas! Don't just condense it down into one subject and let it flourish. That actually sounds like a really good idea. Great, even. Yeah. That's very helpful. Thank you, Wendy. Oh no, I'm just saying all of this to myself for when I get the chance to take my life back from you. Can I get my life back from you? Get bent. Well, I tried. Well, good luck with your midlife crisis! Also, can I ask for one thing? And what will that be? Can I take your dog? No! No! I'm not letting you take my dog! Ah, fine. And for that, I'm gonna tell you that I ate all the chicken Kievs in your freezer. Wait a minute. I just did shopping. Did you just eat the Kievs straight out of the freezer? Maybe. Out! Jesus. Ay-yi! This is stressing me out. I need something to eat. Something to get my mind off of things.
Right, let's see what we got here.
Definitely in the mood for some chicken. Where's the chicken wings?
Come on, that's just taking the pit. Son of a bitch! Wendy, I swear to God I'll-
Who's a what?
Drew! What are you doing here? You're stealing stuff from my freezer too? And how'd you even get all the way over here to Scotland via bad green screen effect?
Why are you calling me Drew? Oh, because Xavier's uncle. I get it. Alright, whatever. Well, anyway, Hexit Brexit. After getting kicked out of that other ginger cosplayer with low self-esteem's house, I needed somewhere else to... survive. And you seem, most convenient.
Right, listen here, you Nirvana fashion wannabe. I'm gonna go out to get more chicken because clearly I've run out! And by the time I get back, you better be gone!
The sound quality sure is different in this half of the room.
Oi! You gonna finish your sandwich while you're at it?
Ah! Oh, why did that hurt so much?
Hey. You gonna use that?